Hey everyone, I'm Abby from Technical Support. This month, we've got some new stuff to show you. So let's start. First up, custom goals. Having a goal block after specific questions will help you mark and identify when a user has reached an important step in the conversation. And now you can create and track multiple goals within the flow and see new custom analytics. For example, we'll create a goal block here in the flow after the user has shown interest in our product and has provided their contact information. You can give each goal a custom name within the block's configuration. We'll call this one Lead. Also, you can easily create a goal block between two connected blocks by using a shortcut and clicking on the arrow. We'll call this goal Collaboration Request. To check the goal metrics, go to the Analyze/Metrics section of your bot, where first you'll see the bot's overall basic metrics. Select one of the goals you've already created, and you'll be able to see the number of users that have reached the chosen goal and its respective rate. Next up, a new WhatsApp message template section, where you can easily request and manage interactive media templates. You can access it from the WhatsApp channel, and you'll see the list of all of your HSM templates with their corresponding status, name, language, and category. It's possible to search a template by name, and you can filter them by status and check the ones which have been approved, rejected, or are still pending. If you switch to preview, you can see how the template will look before sending it. Also, here you can add a new translation to the template. In this new section, you can also request a new message template in just two steps. During the first step, we'll name it, choose a category that fits our use case, and choose a language for the template's content. In the second step, we'll customize our template. You can add a header, which can be a title, image, or document. Here you'll just specify what kind of header you want to have, but you'll be able to actually add the content when sending the template. Here's the body of the message template. If you prefer, you can add a footer. And now you can add the buttons to the message. There are two types of buttons. The first is Quick Reply that allows the customer to easily respond to message template with up to three predefined answers. And the second is a call to action. That can either be visit a website or call phone number. And that's all there is to it. We can preview the template on the right side and click on the submit button. Next one, improvements to the question date block. Now you can set available dates and you have four options for that. You can set all dates as available. You can allow users to select only past dates from today or only future dates. Finally, you can set a custom range. This option allows creating specific date ranges, and we can add as many ranges as we want. It's even possible to create open ranges. For example, from today and with no end date. In the next section of the block's configuration, we can disable specific days of the week. And combining it with the previous availability setting, you get something pretty cool and useful, for example, to book meetings. The last thing here is that you can choose to show a date picker or not. Just keep in mind that if you have set availability settings and you choose not to show the date picker, those aren't going to be visible to the user. So it's better to make it clear in the bot's message. And last but not least, a few style improvements in the bot's design. The no chat bubble style is now applicable to both user and bot messages. Here you can see the difference in design. One has the no chat bubble activated while the other one doesn't. Also, the images now follow the shape of the chat bubble. So if the chat bubble is rounded, then the images will also be rounded, like you can see in this example. And finally, you can make the button text bold, formatting the text like this, inside of the builder. And that's all for this month. Remember that all this new content is in the community. So if you want to stay updated, be sure to join. See you around.